Hello, my name is Tom Kleich. I'm the National Fleet Account Manager for Horton. And today we're at the Horton Corporate Headquarters in Roseville, Minnesota. And we're working on an international LT with an A26 engine. And I'm going to show you how to replace the air cartridge on a DM Advantage on-off modular fan drive. This truck came in with an air leak that was coming out the back of the fan drive. That indicates that it's the air cartridge inside the fan drive. And we're going to show you how to replace the cartridge on the vehicle today. We'll start by taking the fan blade off. Yeah, there's six nuts, washers, and lock washers that you have to remove. And pull the fan blade off, making sure not to damage the radiator, and set down into the truck. Okay, the next step is going to be removing the four nuts on the back of the clutch pack. And to do that, I have a 13 millimeter line wrench and a dead blow hammer. It can be difficult to turn the clutch pack to get all four of the nuts off. And I like to use a tool that Horton provides. It's a fan mounting friction disc removal tool. You can put that on the studs, the fan studs, and then put a ratchet in there to help turn that around so you can get access to the other nuts. Now that we have the clutch pack out, it's a good time just to double check the friction liner. The friction liner is worn below 11/32 of an inch, and it's time to replace the whole clutch pack assembly rather than just putting an air cartridge and a face seal. So Horton has liner gauges that you can use. It's a go, no go. It's used for either our two speed or on off. This happens to be an on off modular clutch, so we're gonna use the on off side. You hold it up against the friction disc. And as you can see, we still have the green where the liner is. If that liner started to wear, we would get into the red area. Once it's all red, it's time to replace the clutch pack and not just replace the cartridge and face seal. We're gonna grab our new kit. Here's the face seal and the air cartridge and new snap ring. So next we're gonna remove the old snap ring and old cartridge out of the assembly on the truck. Okay, now we're gonna install the new air cartridge and snap ring. I like to put a little O-ring lube on the cartridge. Make sure you keep the tip clean. Clean off with a clean rag if you have it. The snap ring is directional, so it's got a beveled edge on one side and flat on the other. The flat goes in towards the clutch. And at this point, I like to take a clean rag just to wipe that the tip of that cartridge off once again before we install the clutch pack. Now we're going to replace the face seal. We'll have to remove the old face seal. And replace it with a new face seal that came in our air cartridge face seal kit. And make sure we grab our inch pound torque wrench. And this will be torqued to 62 inch pounds. Once we get the new face seal installed, the clutch pack is ready to go back on the vehicle. When installing the clutch pack, we want to put the nuts on. Not all the way. We're going to start each nut, the four nuts, to hold that on, so one at a time. Once they're all on, then we can turn them all down and tighten them up. If you don't do it that way, you won't be able to get the nuts because there's not enough clearance. Won't be able to get the nuts on. Once those four nuts are tight, then we're going to put our fan blade back on. We'll put our flat washer, lock washer, and nut back on the fan. We're going to snug those up, and that will complete the job.